It's 6 a.m. Today is hopefully the day I get my new closed loop pump. The cat is here. I am also here and awake. My parents are downstairs. And it's boiling.
So the problem with having anxiety and PTSD from medical stuff is that before we're going to the hospital, I'm now thinking, oh gosh, what if my insulin pump isn't there? What if I've got the wrong day? What if I misinterpreted what they were offering me and I've made a big deal out of something that isn't a thing? But I think we're going in about an hour. So I'm hoping the insulin pump is there and we get set up and it's all good. I should tell you what I'm getting actually. So I'm getting an updated one of these, 780 I want to say, with their own sensors, which should talk to each other.
So I've arrived at the hospital 5 minutes before my appointment and the door's locked. So that's a good start. Excellent, really, really putting me at ease. So I'm just chilling, waiting to go in. My mask, but there's no sign of the diabetes nurse. The reception has turned up now, so hopefully we'll be going in soon and then I can show you the new pump and hopefully the guardian sensors as well. Hopefully it's going to be a really easy setup, but really waiting to see.
I'm updating from here because I'm fed up. I've had enough. So we got home, everything was going fine. The sensor was giving me nice glucose readings. And then I had to calibrate it, which turns out you have to do once 2 hours after you insert it, and then once 6 hours after you insert it. Now, it said I was having a hypo. I didn't agree. I did a BN and a Libre scan because I left this in. And it turns out that the sensor is really, really wrong. So I put the new calibrated number in and it goes, I don't accept that. I'm just going to stop working. And so it hasn't been working for 2 hours. And if it doesn't start working again, I will have to change the sensor. Now, the experience I had in the hospital was that I almost fainted, had to lie on the ground. Because when I put the needle in, if you're squeamish, don't listen to this bit, like skip ahead. But I put the needle in and then it started forcing its way back out of my body. I think because of my stomach muscles, what little I have. And then it started bleeding and it was really gross. And I can't go through that again twice in the same day, only to have this other one not work as well. And then the other thing that's gone wrong is I tried to order my supplies and I went on the account I normally go on. Normally it says zero. Over a grand. So I've got a new pump, which at least is working. I've got a sensor that doesn't work. So I've now got three things in my body because good job I didn't take the Libre out. And then... And I remember my friend a few years ago now, when she got one of these, was like, it is a nightmare. There are so many problems with it. And I kind of assumed that in the 4 years since then, they might have improved. But I'm now just like, have I made the wrong choice? Am I stuck with something that doesn't work for me for 4 years? Because that's how long you have in the funding cycle. This thing that I thought was gonna change my life, like, it could be a fucking nightmare. And also, just look at it. Hang on. Look at it. It's massive. It's massive and it's bleeding. And I'm not happy. Plus, my blood sugar levels have now gone really high because sensor was misreading and I was worried about having a hypo. And I feel bad for showing you this because I feel like shit. I'm really upset and I don't want people to think that like, this is always how it goes, but this is the reality of right now. And maybe I'll come back to you in a week and be like, actually, it was fine. It was just teething problems. But right now, I am so annoyed and so tired. And I was so stressed about this. And there was a little moment where I thought it was actually going okay. And now it's not again. And I don't know how long it's going to take to get this sorted. So yes. Tomorrow is a new day. I'm upset and annoyed and I give up. Diabetes and robot organs suck. Day two of Medtronic 780G with Guardian 4 sensor has been a wild ride. Overnight it wasn't calibrating, but eventually it kind of caught up with me. So I think by 7 o'clock this morning it was accurate. However, it needs constant calibration and I'm really scared of putting the next sensor back in. Today has just been a day of medical admin, really, because it turns out, I found out this morning that I can't order any pump supplies because it's charging me thousands of pounds, which is what you would pay if you were not under the NHS. So it's been phone calls to the doctors, to the nurses, to Medtronic, trying to sort that out, because I only have 4 sensors. So if I muck up a sensor change or it isn't working, I don't have a backup. I think if you're getting a new pump that you're not familiar with, or you're changing supplies of any kind, you need at least a day to get the thing set up and at least a day to do the medical chasing required, because I can't imagine what doing this and trying to do a full day's work would be like, especially not given it's like 25 degrees outside right now and it was about 28. Yeah, so this issue with the sensors is going to be interesting, because if I run the sensor for 3 weeks, which is what I've got the sensors for, and then the new ones don't arrive, I just have to stop using the loop and I don't know what happens then. So I guess this is a question I'll have to ask when I see the nurse next week to start the loop. You know, say, is it sensible to do this? I do want to start it because I know it could be incredible. But also I'm really nervous to start it in case something goes wrong. And I don't know that I trust the equipment yet. I'm sure that'll take time. I'll show you what the sensor looks like in a bit, because it's gnarly. It's what I'd call it right now. It's not painful, doesn't hurt at all. It's just bigger and it looks very medical. Whereas my Libre does not. It looks like I've stuck a Mento to my arm. So yeah, just feeling really overwhelmed, tired. My parents wake up at 5 a.m, which means I've been waking up between 5 and 7 the last 2 days. And my chronic fatigue is really flaring up because I haven't had a nap. So thank you, Mum and Dad, for looking after me for 24 hours. They've now gone, so I'm on my own with this. But it might mean I actually get a decent sleep. We'll see. Day two. I'm scared to have a bath because I'm worried the sensor will come off in the bath. I love baths. Hello and welcome to Becky's really quite distressing morning. We are about to do a sensor change because mine failed after 3 days. So I'm going to put you here. We're going to put it in my arm. I've got a nice man called Rob on my phone who's going to show me how to do it. So I am probably mildly sunburnt. I have also just exfoliated to scrub all of the sun cream off me so that this thing sticks. It's probably going to bleed. Let's be realistic here. And I probably won't be able to get it out of my arm because there is a needle in it. So without further ado, let's do that. When I said that this thing looked like a medieval torture device, see if I can get it to focus. This is probably quite blurry, but this is what I mean. It is big and scary looking. We do not love it, but this is what we're dealing with. Right, I was just literally just getting a mirror to help with this process. Now, I assume this is kind of like a Libre, where I can just sort of shove it
wherever I like. So let's go with here. Oh, can you tell I'm trying to be confident when I'm really, really not? Okay. Okay. And we're in. Okay. Okay. Right. So I think the next bit is the sticky. I don't know how to do this. Okay. Right. We're on. And then it's pulling the needle out. So I think what I need to do is, I think Rob, how did you do this? Held it with, how do I do this? Hold it. Right, we're gonna have to consult Rob.
Okay. I'm going to hold my sensor base right here, and then I'm gonna remove the adhesive.
Okay, we're out. Okay, we're out. We're out, we're out, we're out. It's on, I think it's bleeding, but we're out. Alright, I've got my tape.
And we're gonna place it over our sensor.
Liner coming off. We're going to remove the liner that's labeled 2. I cannot see what I'm doing. Hang on. Oh, right, hang on, Rob. Slow down. Right. Okay. So we've got arm. Think. Move the tab out the way. And we're going over like this. Oh, I'm making a right pixie of this. There we go. Okay, and then we're going that one and that one. Okay. Okay. We're on. Okay, we're fully charged. Okay, so what I need to check at this point is that actually I've done the right thing with the pump. Starting the sensor. Searching for sensor signal. What's that? Paired devices, meter, sensor. Okay. What happens if I go on sensor? Time left. CGM. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to unplug this little pod here. Whoop. It's hopefully going to flash. There we go, we've got little green flashy flashies. Kind of sad I don't flash when it's not, but hey. And then we're going to plug it in. So we're going here, like that. And we're listening for a click. Okay, hang on a second. Okay, so we seem to have the start new sensor. I don't know if that's flashed. We seem to be in. I will confirm later whether this has freaking worked. I didn't pass out, so I'd call that a win. But if this one doesn't work, I swear to God, I'll see you in 2 hours, because that's how long this thing takes to warm up.
Hello, welcome to Really Tired Woman tries to do a roundup of having this new insulin pump system. I've been really high today. The system, I've tried to leave it alone, but it's been like up to like 16 and I've been lingering around the 9-10 area and it's made me feel quite fatigued. On the whole, I'm not as terrified of it as I was. We've done two sensor changes now. And that's gone pretty well. I just really hope that the sensors that were promised do arrive, because I'm still worried that I'm just going to run out and then we just go back into manual mode. But all in all, if it actually does work the way it claims to, then this could be really good. I feel like the amount of information I had before I started it maybe wasn't enough. But hey. So we are running at 4.9 and dropping. So actually I may end up having hypo, which would be a first for today. But yeah, if you found this helpful, if you learned something about this system that you didn't know before, you're very welcome.
welcome. I hope that if you are thinking about getting this pump system, that you get the information you need and deserve. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in some more usual sewing related content soon. But for now, thank you for coming with me for the biggest tech change that I've had happen to me in about 14 years. It's been interesting. Until next time, catch you later.